As we forecast on 10 News First last month, Qantas is standing down another 2,500 domestic staff, more victims of COVID restrictions. Qantas boss Alan Joyce says it will be months before Australians are travelling normally again as we grapple with the Delta strain. National Affairs editor Hugh Rimmington has the latest.
The echoing emptiness of the terminals tells the story.
Aviation workers have been through 18 months of hell.
This is clearly the last thing we wanted to do.
2,500 Qantas and Jetstar domestic pilots, cabin and some ground crew will be stood down, adding to 6,000 international staff who've been stood down already for months.
It is reasonable to assume that Sydney borders will be closed for at least another 2 months.
The Commonwealth has tweaked support, so wherever in the country they're stood down, the Qantas and Jetstar domestic staff will get a $750 a week emergency payment. But in a tough call for ground crew, caterers, aircraft cleaners, baggage handlers outside COVID hotspots will see none of the money.
We would love to give, if we had unlimited funds, we could give it to everybody for an unlimited period of time. That is just not possible.
There'd be well in excess of 10 or 12,000 workers that have fallen into a hole here, a black hole, of no support.
Alan Joyce says COVID has cost his airline $16 billion in revenue, and that figure goes up every single day. He's still clinging to the hope that international flights might be back by Christmas, but he says that depends on caseloads and vaccines.
Australia just needs more people rolling up their sleeves as more vaccine arrives.
Until then, tonight, thousands more Australian households are doing their sums, trying to figure out how they will get by. Hugh Rimmington for 10 News First.